I'll just be really simple this time. I don't wanna joke about this. Today I'll be talking about Beholder, a game that talks about the life of a landlord in a dictatorship. Especially inspired by the current state of Russia and China and those kind of countries where people are constantly under control and scrutiny. I feel for you. I hope the future gets better one day, and this review is outdated. Back to the game, we have a poor family that is forced to move after a non-better specified event, but something to do with our protagonist, the father, getting accidentally close to something that doesn't agree with the regime. We come at a time where our nondescript country is tired from a long war with a border enemy. It appears that we're slowly losing ground, and to distract the public, the dictator and his yes men are banning things left and right, also creating patriotic activities, in short, all sorts of distractions to entertain the public. Even if I think the guy in charge is long dead, especially since, allegedly, they have something around 120 years. What do you think? Are they alive? Also, this seems like a test or a punishment for what I described earlier. The story is very malleable in the sense that you're in control of almost everything that happens in your condo complex. There's three main ways the game can end, but also with multiple nuanced options. You can be another yes man and do everything the dictatorship tells you, or go alone to not be arrested and end the game early so that you can contribute to free the country. You can also play the goody two shoes and try to please everybody, but the most important times will be time and money. Those are your accessories, your most fundamental tokens. Time, because you'll get tasks from three different parties: your tenants and family, the dictatorship, and the revolution. And do what you like, but I played the game only once. It's such a serious story with such incredible dialogue and characters, including our protagonist, that are all less than perfect. It just goes to show how much a situation like this makes it hard for people to be really good. Everybody will say something that you shouldn't say to people at a certain point. Real life is like that, after all. If a game needs to imitate what the worst aspects of life can become, it needs to have dialogue of this caliber. And I played it once because there's two difficulties in it, but I decided to go with the hardest one because the developers themselves called it the intended way to finish Beholder. And what ending did I get? My entire family, including me, died, but I stopped the war and ended the dictatorship. Not immediately, they make it go very realistically, with years and years of work from the public and the new government to fix many things. And they make it clear that there's still a ways to go even after that. But I get caught trying to flee the country, and those days those changes still didn't happen. I was, anyway, very satisfied with this result, since I played this blind, meaning I didn't search for any solution online. It's how I play games in my life. Unless I get stuck for some time, I don't search for solutions. What's the point otherwise? The game makes perfect sense because of the second element that comprises the experience. Time always moves. Actually, not true. When you talk to people, time stops, fortunately. Since there's a lot of dialogue in Beholder, I thank the developers for this neat feature. It's already pretty stressful as it is, so I can't blame anybody for feeling very grateful in this case. Not all tasks require time, but the Miss Pivotal do. The problem with them is that they get very repetitive 3 hours in. There's not a lot of variety to carry this 6 to 7 hour game. At the midway point, you'll have seen everything Beholder has to offer and then some. They throw a couple new things near the end, but only if you choose to do the revolutionary path. Makes sense since you have to do more creative things, in general, to overthrow a regime, but still you might not see those depending on your choices. And it's real choices in everything you do. You get money, you spend money, sometimes without you knowing. In both cases, every once in a while, you also have to at least profile your tenants, and that means putting cameras in their houses to see if they're violating any directive. Also, just to be sure, breaking in to get information on banned items your tenants might own. Of course, without them knowing or being in the house, otherwise they get angry. It might turn out useful since you get the opportunity to use this kind of knowledge in some tasks, so try to know who you have in your care. Also, the people that want to inhabit the premises change depending on your choices. And the best part about the entire decision system is that it's all hidden away, not overt, and very gamified like Telltale Games or other titles that make the branching paths their main event. I really don't like Telltale Games, okay? I've mentioned them in the past, but that's how it is. As you see with me praising Beholder, I don't have a problem with dialogue or text-heavy games. It's just the Telltale style that feels wrong to me. Opinions are like Castles, and I'm Walter Matthaus in Dennis the Menace, an old disillusioned gamer with a heart of gold. There's many other little things, but I'll let you discover them, otherwise there's no fun. Now, I wanna talk about the art style, because we see like this, colorless and depressing, and this time it fits. I'm actually motivated by this oppressive rainy weather to do my things and move away from this place as soon as possible. So good job on the artists, because they really nailed the feeling. And the music is even better, because it's mostly subtle, but swells up for the most important moments, not in happy ways. It's all very depressing or anxiety-inducing, so that you never are asleep at the job. Oh my, even saying that phrase is kind of scary. When you come down to it, I think Beholder is a fantastic 8 out of 10. The fact that such a short game manages to be already so repetitive puts it down a bit. Could have been much more, but it wasn't meant to be. If you wanna see me play the games that I will review, plus some extra stuff, catch me on Twitch at ArachneRetro. Same name that I use on Twitter, where I will keep you updated with everything I am doing, and more. See ya, at the next review, ciao ciao!